Hello, Kunal. Myself, Rakesh Dangi. Today, we are going for another video lecture session. In last video lecture session, we completed question number 1, 2, 3 in overhead accounts. So, here we today going for question number 4. As you seen on your screen, question number 4, the Jyoti Textile Limited has 3 production departments, Department A, Department B, and Department C, and Service Department D. The following figures are available for March 2011 of 25 working days of 8 hours each day. જ્યોતિ ટેક્સટાઇલ લિમિટેડમાં 3 ઉત્પાદન વિભાગ છે, એ, બી અને સી, અને એક સર્વિસ ડિપાર્ટમેન્ટ છે, ડિપાર્ટમેન્ટ ડી. નીચે જે માહિતી છે 2011ના વર્ષના માર્ચ મહિનાના 25 કામકાજના દિવસો છે, એના દરરોજ 8 કલાક કામ કરે છે એની માહિતી છે. સુપરવાઇઝર સેલરી છે, રેન્ટ, પાવર, ઇલેક્ટ્રિસિટી, લેબર, વેલફેર એક્સપેન્સ એન્ડ અધર એક્સપેન્સ. યુ આર ગિવન ધ એડિશનલ ઇન્ફોર્મેશન, એ ઉપરાંત બીજી વધારાની માહિતી છે જેમાં નંબર ઓફ વર્કર્સ, એપોર્શન ઓફ સુપરવાઇઝર સેલરી, ફ્લોર એરિયા સ્ક્વેર ફીટમાં, સર્વિસ રેન્ડેડ બાય સર્વિસ ડિપાર્ટમેન્ટ એ, બી અને સી વચ્ચે કઈ રીતે કામ આપે છે, 35%, 30% એન્ડ 35%. કેલ્ક્યુલેટ લેબર રેટ ફોર ઈચ ઓફ ધ ડિપાર્ટમેન્ટ એ, બી, સી. નાવ વી આર ગોઈંગ for answer of this question. Very first we have to prepare a statement showing allocation of overhead. In this statement there is a column of particular, basis of apportionment, total rupees, main department, there is a production department. In production department there is 3 section, A, B and C, and last one is service department, there is only 1 section, department B. Now first overhead expense, supervisor salary, total rupees 20,000. Basis of apportionment, as we read in question, there is a apportionment of supervisor salary is given in percentage, 30%, 20%, 20% and 30%. So ratio of that percentage is 3:2:2:3. Now we divide 20,000 in 3:2:2:3 ratio. So it will be 6,000, 4,000, 4,000 and 6,000. Then factory rent, obviously it is divided in area occupied for a floor area, which is given in square feet, 600, 800, 600, 500. So ratio 6:8:6:5. So now total factor rent rupees 5,000 should be divided in 6:8:6:5 ratio. So it is rupees 1,200, 1,600, 1,200 and 1,000. Third expense is power and electricity. Total amount is 11,000. In additional information, there is power and electricity already we read. It is divided in 2,000, 3,000, 3,600 and 2,400. It is already given 11,000 in allocated form. So there is no any ratio required for allocation of that expense. Next is a worker welfare expense. Worker welfare or a labor welfare expense. It is rupees 4,800. So obviously it is divided in ratio of number of workers. There is a number of workers in department A, 80 workers, in department B, 60 workers, in department C, 60 workers, and department D, 40 workers. So ratio is 8:6:6:4. তারপরে 4:3:2:2 there is some mistake workers number of workers ratio 86664 so 4332 4:3:2:2 8664 5:3:2:2 So 4800. Sorry, there is a worker welfare ratio in proportion of number of workers. Number of worker 80, 60, 60, 40. So 5:3:3:2. 4800 divided in that ratio. So 1600. There is some mistake. So 4332. Yes. 4:3:2:2 It is the original ratio 4332. So divide in 4800 in 4332. It is 1600, 1200, 1200, and 800. Last expense, other expense. There is no data given, but in additional information there is other. In other expense is already allocated. In question 1,300, 400, 5,000, and 1,800. So as per given, it is allocated in that ratio or in that form. So total expense rupees 11,800 for department A, 13,200 for department B, 15,000 for department C, and 12,000 for department D. Now, a portion of service department expense. There is only one service department, department D, which is given service to production department ABC in ratio 35%, 30%, and 35%. So in second table, first one, total overhead expense as per above statement, department A, 11,800, department B, 13,200, department C, 15,000, department D, 12,000. Now expense, total expense of department D, service department, which is now allocated among production department ABC in that service ratio 35%, 30%, 35%. So it will be 4,200, 3,600, 4,200. Here less 12,000 total allocation. So now total overhead for production department is now 16,000, for department B 16,800. For department C, 19,200, and department D, there is a zero. Now, total of working hours, there is a 25 working days in a month and 8 hours each of the working hours. So, department A, total working hours in department A, there is 80 workers work in department A. So, 80 number of workers multiplied 25 days. Multiply 8 working hours per day is equal to 16,000 hours of the month, which is working in department A. Same way in department B, number of workers 60, working days 25, working hours per day 8, so is equal to 12,000 working hours of the month in department B. Same way in department C, there is 60 odd number of workers, 25 days, 8 working hours, so 12,000 hours. Now, direct worker hour rate, it means its formula is total overhead expense divided by working hours of a particular department. So in department A, there is 16,000 working hours divided by 16,000 as per in table 2, here exactly highlighted by me. So is equal to rupees 1 working hour rate. In department B, there is working hours, 16,800 total overhead expense divided by 12,000 working hours. This divided by this is equal to 1.40 rate hour. In department C, there is 19,200 total overhead expense, total working hours 12,000. So 19,200 divided by 12,000 is equal to 1.60. Now, next question. Question number 5. Alkes Limited has 3 production department, department A, department B, and department C, and service department Z. It is same question like question number 4. The following figures are available for 1 month of 25 working days of 8 hours each day. Supervisor salary, rent, power, labor welfare, other expense. But there is power and other expense already allocated in the question table. Other information, number of workers, a portion of supervisor salary, floor area in square feet, service rendered by service department. Z is service department. So there is 50% given service to A, 30% to B, and 20% to C. Calculate the labor hour rate for each of department A, B, and C. Now we are going to check of its answer. First one, we prepare a table statement showing allocation of overhead. In table, there is a column particular basis of apportionment, total rupees. There is 2 departments, service and production. As per question, we make here first service department Z, then production department ABC. You can change it. First make production department ABC and last column service department Z as you like. It is your choice. Now, first, there is expense, power and electricity. As per we know, it is already allocated in question. So in basis of apportionment, it is as given, 22,100. So service department Z, it is 480, department A 400, department B 600, and department C 720. Supervisor salary as given, because there is in additional information, supervisor salary divided in ratio already given, 20%, 30%, 30%, 20%. So ratio 2:3:3:2. So now total supervisor salary rupees 4,000 divided in that ratio. So rupees 800 for service department, 1200 for production department A, same way another 1200 for production department B, and last 800 for production department C. Factory rent, obviously it is divided in floor area or occupied space. There is floor area occupied by department ABC is given in additional information in square feet. There is 1000 square feet by department Z, service department it is. Then 1200 square feet by department A, 1600 square feet by department B, and 1200 square feet by department C. So ratio of that square feet is 5:6:8:6. So total overhead expense or a total factory rent of this 2000 should be divided in that ratio of 5686. Then it will be rupees 400 for department Z, 480 for department A, 640 for department B, and 480 for department C. Now worker welfare expense. Worker welfare expense total rupees 1200. It is divided in ratio of number of workers. That is number of workers. Data given in additional information: 10 workers in service department Z, 30 workers in production department A, 40 workers in production department B, and 20 workers in production department C. So ratio of that amount is 1:3:4:2. Now 1200 should be divided in 1, 3, 4, 2 among that department. So 120 for service department Z, 360 for A, 480 for B, 240 for C. Last one, other expense, which is already allocated in question. Total expense rupees 2400 in service department Z, 400, production department A, 400, B, 800, and C, also 800. Now total of that department expense, so in department service department Z, there is total 2200. Department A 2840, department B 3720, department C 3040. Now this total of service department expense should be divided among production department as per data given. So now we prepare second table or second statement, apportionment of service department expense among production department. There is a production department 3, A, B, C, and service department Z. As per data given in question, service rendered by service department to production department in 50%, 30%, 20% ratio. But here we first note down or write down total overhead expense of each department as per we calculating table, above table. In production department, there is 2,840. In production department B, 3,720. Production department C, 3,040. And service department Z, 2,200. Now distribute that expense of service department Z. In 50%, 30%, 20% ratio. So total 2,200. Will be divided in 50%, 30%, 20%. So it will be 1100 or 1100, 660, 440. Here total 2200 allocated among the production department. So there is negative 2200. So finally, total overhead expense of production department A is 3940, production department B 4380. Production department C 3480 and service department now 0. Now work note for total of working hours. As per data given in question, there is working days in a month is 25 and working hours per day 8 hours. So now total working hours of each department A, B, C. First one, number of workers in department A, there is 30 workers, multiply 25 working days, multiply 8 working hours per day is equal to 6,000 working hours of the month in department A. Same way, in department B, there is 40 number of workers, multiply 25 working days, multiply 8 working hours per day is equal to 8,000 working hours of department B. In department C, there is 20 number of workers, 25 working days of the month, 8 working hours of the working hours per day is equal to 4000 working hours of department C. Now we calculate answer. Direct working hour rate is equal to total overhead expense of a particular department divided by working hours of a particular department. So now for department A, there is overhead expense as per table 2, 3940 divided by working hours of department A 6000 is equal to 0.66. It is a labor hour rate or working hour rate. For department B, there is 4380 total overhead expense divided by total working hours 8000 is equal to 0.55. Same way for department C, there is a overhead expense 3480 working hours 4000 is equal to 0.87. There is a highest labor hour rate or a working hour rate in department C, 0.87, and lowest in department B, 0.55. It is very simple question. Please make a proper notebook.